हेलो स्टूडेंट्स एंड वेलकम टू द न्यू लेक्चर सेशन। मैं सेल्फ शंखु घोष, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर ऑफ ऑटोमोबाइल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट एट डॉक्टर सुधीर चंद्र सूद डिग्री इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज अंडर द GIS ग्रुप। टुडे विल डिस्कस अ न्यू टॉपिक that is x by y under the module number of 6, that is x by y technology. This module is taken from the subject of modern vehicle technology. This is the subject of 7th semester automobile engineering students and the subject code is AUE 704B. So students, today we discuss on XYY technology. The objective of this technology is that to understand about the XYY technology over the conventional uses technology. Then we'll study on the history of its various types of its working principle, its various types, its components. And then we'll discuss elaborately the various classification of this XYY technology. So students, let's start the today's class on XYY technology. Introduction. Drive-by-wire or DBW is a catch-all term that can refer to a number that can refer to a number of electronic system that takes the place of old mechanical control instead of using cables, hydraulic pressure and other things that provide the driver with direct physical control over the speed or direction of wheels. Drive-by-wire technology uses electronic control to activate the brakes, control the steering and operate other systems. So students, instead of the using cable, hydraulic pressure and the other things that provide the driver with direct or physical control over the speed of direction of a vehicle, and the drive-by wire technology uses the electronically controlled to activate the brakes, control the steering and operate the other system. The term also might be familiar to aviation. Since airplane have been this system which is called fly-by-wire in the year of 1990s. So since the 1990s where the aeroplane used this system and it is known as the fly-by-wire or FBW. That technology just like drive-by-wire use electrical wire to control the normal operation of a plane. Use electrical to control the normal operation of a plane. Over the years, manufacturers and outside researchers and the inventors have been integrating computers and electronics into modern cars. Computer and electronics into the modern car. If drivers could simply get accustomed to the idea, drive-by-wire systems have the potential to increase the comfort, functionality and safety during the drive. Computer and the sensor would analyze the commands and instruct the vehicles on exactly what to do. So computer and the sensor would analyze the commands and instruct the vehicles on exactly what to do. And by where system have been environmental angle, have an environmental angle too. Since the technology improve the fuel economy and reduces or improve the engine emissions also. So beside the increase in the driver's comfort and easy to vehicle control, beside this they also use this technology is also helpful for the environmental angle. That's through the improvement of the fuel economy and reducing or the improving the engine emissions. Now coming to the history. The first bi-wire system have been developed in aviation. In huge aircraft hydraulic and mechanical connection. Between input devices of a pilot and the actuator have been replaced by the electronic wire. The pilot gives his commands by the cockpit control computer or FCC. The pilot gives his command by the cockpit controls to a flight control computer or the FCC, which controls, that means the flight control computer controls several electric motors, and the hydraulic pump. Chevrolet Corvette in the year of 1980. Chevrolet Corvette introduced the concept of throttle by wire, which is also known as the gear by wire, and it implemented in some high-end vehicle, such as BMW 5 and the 7 series. In the year of 1995, BMW Technic began working on the project. The BMW technician began to work on the project, that is Z22, to change the carbon fiber structure to drive by the wire. BMW technician started to working on a project. The project is Z22 to change the carbon fiber structure to the drive by the wire. Then in the year of 1998, aircraft technology using computerized joystick. In the year of 2002, high wire car by General Motors. And year of 2009, where the Assault System SolidWorks releases, And in the year of 2010, introduce the sensor for the paddle. Introduce sensors for the paddle. Now coming to the XY wire. Embedded electronics and more preciously embedded software. Embedded electronics or more preciously embedded software it is. It is the first growing area and is the first growing area and software based system are increasingly replaced the mechanical and or the hydraulic ones. The area for this evolution, the reasons for this evolution are technological as well as the economical. On the other hand, the cost of hardware component, is decreasing, while their performance and reliability are increasing. On another hand, electronic technology facilitates the introduction of new functions whose development would be costly or not even feasible if using mechanical or the hydraulic systems alone. This evolution formerly confined to function such as motor control, wipers, lights or door controls now affect all car domains, even for the critical functions such as the throttle, brake or steering control. This trend resulted in the introduction of the concept that is XY wire, where mechanical or hydraulic system embedded in an automotive application will be replaced by the fully electric or the electronic ones. Historically, the first critical XY wire function was throttle by wire. Which is implemented in a Chevrolet Corvette series in the year of 1980 to replace the cable-based throttle. Today, this function is present in most vehicles. For example, Peugeot 307. Shift by wire system is also known. The shift by wire system, which is also known as the gear by wire, are also implemented in some high-end vehicle. That is BMW 5 and 7 series. However, mechanical systems are still necessary for the most currently based XY wire systems, either to work in conjunction with the electronic system or as a backup. For example, the electronic hydraulic braking system, semi-active suspension as in the Mercedes adaptive dumbfunk system, the electronic camshaft in the BMW valvetronic technology or the new robotized gearbox. It is interesting to remark that the robotized gearbox is an option. Proposed by all car makers in this world. today. One of the main obstacles for general acceptance, of XYOR system is the difficulty to prove, that the all the necessary safety measures are followed. It is enough to note, that the dysfunction of steer by wire, brake by wire, or throttle by wire system would jeopardize the safety of the occupants. As seen before, a number of X by wire systems have already been implemented in certain series of vehicles. However, steer by wire and brake by wire system will always have a mechanical backup. The concern for safety is certainly a major factor. Another obstacle is that the customer's demands is not very great at the moment. He does not realize the technical advantages and only sees a higher price tag. But the advantages of this technology, can be very attractive for both car makers and the customers, which explain why car makers are investing in this domain. Now coming to the basic description. There is a trend in the automotive industry towards eliminating mechanical and the hydraulic control system and replacing them with the electronic control. Many traditional mechanical components can be eliminated, such as shafts, pumps, hoses, fluids, coolers, cylinders, etc., which reduces the weight of the vehicle and improve the efficiency. Electronic controls can also improve safety by facilitating more automated control function. Like stability control. They also enhance the flexibility of automotive system, making it easier to modify or upgrade the vehicle. Electronic controls improve handling, enable the better fuel efficiency, and exhibit the shorter response time in emergency situation. The complexity of the system control function enabled by the electronic system can make vehicle performance more difficult to model. And integrating this complex system, vehicle achieving predictable, fail-safe performance represents a significant challenge for the automotive industry. This XYOR technology is the main components are ECM, or the engine control module, sensors, and the actuators. These three are the main components. One is ECM, or engine control module. Number two is sensor, and number three is actuator. Now coming to the working principle. Drive by wire, where works on the electromechanical control system. The main control system is ECM, or the engine control module. Sensor sends some signals to the ECM, and ECM sends the and actuates the actuators, sends signals to ECM and actuators for actuates. ECM is connected to the several system. ECM is connected to the several system. When ECM is control the signal and circulate the signal to the suitable system. Now come to the classification of this X, Y, Y technology. So classically, this X, Y, Y technology is classified in this three way. Number one is steer by wear. Number two is brake by wear. And number three is throttle by wear. So student, let's start with this steer by wear. The steer by wear or SBW system is one part of the drive by wire system that the automobile industry will research in future. The new drive by wire or DBW systems will replace mechanical and hydraulic system for steering, braking, suspension and the throttle function with the electronic actuators and controller and the sensors. The drive-by-wire system will improve overall vehicle safety driving. Overall the vehicle safety overall vehicle safety driving convenience and the functionality significant. An SBW system is one in which the conventional mechanical linkage between the steering wheel and the front wheel are removed, that the system is operated by the electronic actuators. The steer-by-wire system has many merits compared with the conventional steering system with a mechanical linkage. To begin with, the SBW system can reduce a vehicle weight by reducing the number of necessary parts, which can lead to energy reduction effectiveness. In addition, the danger of a driver being crushed when there is a front end collision is eliminated as there is no steering column. Finally, the most valuable merit is that it permits automatic steering and the vehicle stability control to be free. The SBW system consists of steering wheel, that is number one, angle sensor for the steering wheel, that is two, road sense motor, that is three, current sensor for the road sense motor, that is four, steering wheel controller, that is five, steering gear controller, that is six, current sensor for steering motor, that is seven, angle sensor, that is nine, worm gear reducer, that is ten, and rack and pinion steering gear, that is 11. So this 11 item is totally consist in the steering by wire system. The steering wheel is actuated by the difference between the drive torque and the road sequence torque from the road sense motor. The angle of steering wheel is measured by the angle sensor and it transmitted to the steering wheel controller. The steering wheel controller transmit the angle message to the steering gear controller through CAN bus, which is used to calculate the reference angle for the steering gear of rack and pinion. The steering gear is actuated by the torque difference between the steering motor and the aligned torque from the steering actuator and the ground. Now coming to the structural analysis. The steer by wear system changes the original steering system transmission structure. The system operates by the driver and the wheel executes execution system were completely mechanically separated and they made up to independent subsystems. The SVW systems combined these two subsystems together by its control system and the sensors. Control system takes the initiative to adjust the power transfer characteristics of automotive steering by analyzing and calculating the state of the vehicle. And it can also design the angle transfer characteristics of the car, which brought infinite space to the design of the vehicle steering characteristics. This SVW system consists of three modules, that is steering wheel module, front wheel steering module, and the controller module. Let's starting with the steering wheel module. The steering wheel module include steering wheel angle sensor, torque sensor, steering wheel aligning torque motor. The main function of the steering wheel module is to pass the driver's steering intent to the master controller and then to control the operation and then to control the operation of the steering module by the electronic control unit or the engine control unit, electronic control unit. In the same time, the ECU sends and that same time ECU sends control signal to steering wheel aligning the torque motor, which make it produces the aligning torque to provide the driver with the road sense information. Next is front wheel steering module. The front wheel steering module is composed of the front wheel angle sensor, steering implementation motor, steering motor controller, front wheel steering components, and so on. The function of the steering assembly is to accept the master control commands and control the front wheels turning by the steering motor controller, which can realize the driver's steering intent. Next one is controller module. The main function of the ECU is to collect sensor signal and analyze the signal by preset control strategy and then send commands to the steering wheel aligning torque motor and the steering motor to control two motors work. The issue should ensure that there must be the ideal vehicle response in a variety of condition. Next is the work characteristics. SVW system cancel mechanical connection. SVW or steering by wire system cancel the mechanical connection between the steering wheel and the front wheels and control their movement by ECU. This can achieve the steering function that the conventional steering system cannot. The steer by wire steering system has the following characteristics. That's improving the steering features, improving the road sense, improving the economy efficiency and protecting the environment, enhancing the stability and security, expanding the research space and reducing the development cost. So let's start with improving steering features. SVW systems can set the angle transmission ratio in real time according to vehicle's driving condition and at the same time compensate the front wheel angle to make sure that the vehicle's steering characteristics remain still. With the removal of the mechanical connection, SVW system can freely design the steering ratio. When the car is at low speed, the steering ratio should be reduced, which can improve the steering sensitivity. Conversely, the steering ratio should be increased when vehicle is at high speed, which can make this steering more stable. SVW handed over the work that should be completed by the driver to the controller, thus can reduce the driver's intensity and improve the steering system's ability to respond to steering input from the driver. Next is improving the road sense. Road sense refer to the turning resistance torque during the driving, which is got from the driver's feeling from the steering wheel's feedback. This torque contains the vehicle and the tire information about movement and the force status, which is very important for the driver to control the vehicle's motion and the environmental condition. In the conventional vehicle, the driver felt road sense through the steering wheel's reaction. Since there is no mechanical connection between the steering wheel and the front wheel in steering by wire system, the driver cannot feel the reaction of the steering wheel. The road sense, that drive needs in is generate from control signal. Control signal supplied by the steering wheel aligning the torque motor. Because the ECU can choose the best signal to reflect the real turning state of the vehicle and the road condition, the driver can be provided with the most useful information and feel his favorite road sense furthermore. Next one is improving the economic efficiency and the protecting the environment. Due to cancelling the mechanical connection, SVW have reduced the weight of the vehicle and the motor output the power only when turning. The system eliminates the bell drive and improve the transmission efficiency. Therefore, the vehicle fuel economy has been improved, energy has been saved, emission has been reduced. Since in this slide, the study of SVW has a huge and far-reaching impetus for the development of vehicle manufacturing industry, and it would represent the future of the vehicle steering systems. Next one is enhancing the stability and security. vehicle was often encountered a variety of complex conditions such as rough road, roadside winds, and low adhesion, and so on. So it can be easily unstable when the vehicle is traveling in this condition. The SVW system can judge the state of the vehicle by collecting sensor signal, and when the vehicle has unstable terrain, it can control the front wheels angle and then control the car back to the steady state. Next is expanding the research space and reducing development cost. SVW system cancels the steering column, pulley, bale, and the other components so that the cab has more space to arrange the specific safety component, which can reduce the harm to the driver when the accident occurs. Since the hardware part has great versatility, the system uses software control and it can be applied to the model if you modify some parameters, and this can be save a lot of time for developing the new model and reduce the cost. So students, today we covered the XYY technology, its working principle, its history, its components, and then we discuss the classification of this XYY. In today's class, we covered the steering Y technology. On the next class, we'll discuss the brake Y technology. So till then, stay at home and stay safe. Thank you. Thank you so much, students.